then the ADA who was assigned to the case came down and asked for $7,500, and then we talked, and we, you know, this bureau, they did a good job of trying to figure out how to get it. It's only right that they did.
Take us into that conversation.
It really was just that. And it was looking at some of the things. You know, I'm a former prosecutor as well. So I think having an intelligent conversation about what happened and the footage that we're looking at, and just looking at the complaint and what's been alleged, I think that the district attorney's office made the right call.
But he came to his conclusion based on the video.
Apparently, yeah.
And so what did that tell you?
I'm very humble about this position. I know there's going to be a certain rush from the New York City Police Department, as always, to protect their own. So I'm not arrogant in thinking anything. Right now, I got September 27th. I guess we're going to, it's supposed to be grand jury action or anything in between. I'm going to attempt to gather as much information as I can and give it to the district attorney's office as well, and let them make a fair assessment. So hopefully it'll work out. But I am prepared to go to trial and go forward to charge these kids with felonies. These officers were hurt at their own, it sounds as bad as it may seem, but they were hurt because of their own behavior. No one wants to talk about that. And,